folks, welcome to the Sloppy Boys, where we take a deep dive into the drinks that you love. I'm Jeff Dutton, along with Mike Hanford.
Ooh, hi.
And Tim Kalpakis.
What is up?
And we are your hosts, the band, the Sloppy Boys.
Now, you can hear us giggling, folks, and it's probably because we are live.
I thought we said we weren't going to talk about it.
We're going to talk about it. We have to talk about it.
We're not live.
We're not live.
This is a mess.
We're alive. That's what I meant to say. We're alive with excitement.
Yeah, we're alive with excitement.
We're alive with excitement because, folks, we are hopefully coming to you on video.
If all goes well,
and if you all pay the Patreon level, you'll see us digitally.
I don't know if that's how it will be.
As far as we know, like, it just means we're rolling on video. We're just seeing each other. Like, we always see each other when we're recording the podcast.
Yeah, this is not really different.
But now maybe the audience could see us.
It's just that we're juiced up.
Yeah, I'm pretty juiced.
I took a shower for this. Usually there's flies buzzing about.
Yeah, your hair looks great.
I know. Well, thanks. I combed it because I knew I was going to be on TV.
Mike, why you got to do the whole shower, and why don't you just kind of wash your head if you're going to only have your face on camera?
Well, I was in the shower. That's what I kind of did, Tim, actually. All of me was in the shower.
Okay. But special emphasis on his head.
Yes. The head got the shampoo and conditioner treatment.
Okay.
And then I just left the ass.
There were some memes a couple years ago about how guys don't wash their legs. That it was like you just kind of watch like the pits and the crotch and the butt, and then
hit the hot spots. Keep moving.
The hot spots. I never really thought about, I don't even know what I was doing before, but ever since that thing was memed, now I'm scrubbing the shit out of these legs, man. I got the bar, I got the Irish Spring right on the calf going.
Well, all that hair really eats up the soap, you know? Yeah. You're like sanding down a good bar. It would have lasted a while.
The bar's got a big curve in the middle of it because where he was...
Kind of does. I'm telling you, I'm back on bars. The body wash era is over. No more loofahs. I'm like a kid in the 90s just grabbing a bar of Zest and putting it right on
just
my body.
Cramming it.
The body wash was a short-lived phenomenon for me. I got it, and I was like, yeah, I'll do the puffer and everything. And then I said, you know what? I like the bar.
I like the bar too, but lately I'm a Bronner's guy. I'm a Dr. Bronner disciple.
But that's in a loofah, right?
I go just chest hair.
Hey, what about legs?
That's kind of what I do. Is that I use the chest hair as a loofah, and then I'm going back for more.
That's Grand Central, and then the suds kind of just go from there.
You detach your chest hair mop.
It's a quick hop to the armpits. That's great. That's no problem.
I'd say just do the armpits and let those things squirrel all around. Scrub the whole thing.
Squirrel all around.
If I could get my armpits to detach and wash the rest of my body, whew, I'd be a rich man.
That would rock.
Mm-hmm. Well, what's going on with you guys?
I wanted to say something about the Dr. Bronner's. I tried that stuff once. And I went too hard on it and went right to some sensitive zones with a full, undiluted...
The nard.
Yeah. And that's not where that's... But it then starts to get real hot. It got real spicy.
You didn't do that thing where you put the nozzle right up to your meatus and then squeeze the bottle and it emptied the whole thing right up into your urethra, did you?
I didn't do that thing.
Oh, yeah. A lot of people are doing that thing.
That one I didn't do.
It is, it's spicy. I love that stuff. And as you know, in college, I read on, it's got the crazy ramblings on the label and it says it's 18-in-1 uses. Mm. And I was using it for all the, I brushed my teeth with it.
That's the one that always sounds crazy to me.
Well, no, the craziest one is that I did my fucking laundry with it.
Wow. Yeah, that is. If you had a dog, you'd wash the dog too.
That's true. But there's a nice uniformity to be like, smell my teeth, now smell my clothes. Same soap.
That's Tim's smell.
Wait, so it's body wash, shampoo, laundry detergent, toothpaste,
dishes.
Dishes.
Floor. Mop the floor?
Yeah, I don't know how they get to 18.
18? Well, they kind of spread it out. They're like, you can do your top teeth. Hey, you can do your bottom teeth too.
Each tooth is a different one.
How many teeth we got? 32? Is that an adult human?
Sounds about right.
Sounds like it.
Yeah, it's not worth Googling. Not on this show.
Nah.
Hey, wait. Flavor-wise, though, you doing peppermint? I'm all peppermint.
Yeah. That. I mean, I have also... I like the almond one because it smells like DiSorono. but the spicy peppermint one is the way to go. And you really scrub hard and then you come out and you're like, ouch. There's a movie about Dr. Bronner himself. And he's demonstrating how you use it. Sometimes he like puts it right on a towel and he rubs it all. But he's like standing naked in his bathroom, toweling down. And he's talking about how to use it. And he's like, first you move your bowels and then you do this. Oh, wow. I'm like, Doc, I'll move my bowels on my own schedule. Don't you worry. That's not your jurisdiction.
I thought you were going to say it's like a movie about Dr. Bronner, like Elijah Wood is Dr. Bronner.
Yeah, like the air treatment or the...
Or I don't know, just like a Hollywood movie. It's just the guy made his own movie and he kicks it off with clearing the bowels.
I mean, the documentary, as far as I remember, goes nowhere. It's like, hey, this is the soap guy. All right.
Dang. Hey, speaking of the multiplex, do I have news for you two?
Yes.
Well, I thought you'd say like, wow, do you? Wow, what's the news?
No, I'm hoping it's Deadpool related.
Is it Deadpool related?
Well, here's the thing. Deadpool, we both know, comes out. We all know, not just
three
both
of us.
July 26, 2024, Ryan Reynolds and Hugh Jackers. And don't forget, Taylor Swift, possibly, rumored.
Oh, right.
But before we have all that fun.
Yeah.
Despicable Me 4, July 3rd. Yes, the boys are back.
I'll be there.
The Minions 2.
Wait, I don't think that we don't cover Minion news. That's we do Deadpool because Mike thinks Ryan Reynolds is the funniest comedian.
No, Tim, Minion news is taking over Deadpool news.
No.
I think Hugh Jackman's the funniest comedian.
Oh, wait till you see this trailer. The Minions are back, baby. I don't care for Gru and his family, but the Minions, God, I love them.
I saw it at a screening of Zone of Interest, which seemed like an interesting pairing for that movie.
Oh, I thought I was breaking news here.
But you didn't even mention, Jeff, that I saw news that the Deadpool has wrapped principal photography.
Wow, that's a good update.
That's Deadpool news. But on the Minion front... Remember when we all three of us were going to see the last Minions movie, and then some slophead recognized one of us in the lobby, was like, "Hey, Mike!
Yeah.
Oh, Jeff! Oh, Tim! Oh, Jesus! All of you!"
Yeah, of course. It was embarrassing.
Oh God! Why are you guys? What are you doing?
But my favorite one of those ever, though, was when we were at the Hopscotch Music Festival and we're making our way through the crowd, and a guy saw Jeff, and then he turned to me and he goes, "Duds." like I just saw Duds. Can you believe that?
Like, you'd be impressed. Like, you've been sitting on a plane with me for 8 hours. Yeah.
Please, you're preaching the choir. Yeah, I know.
Shared a hotel room with him. How about that?
All right, can we get into a little booze news, please?
Sure.
Yes, hit it.
King of Thrones.
My eyes are getting weary. My back is getting tight. I'm sitting here in traffic on the Queensboro Bridge tonight. Cause baby, all my life I will be driving home to you.
King of Thrones was sent to us by Kyle, a.k.a. X-Height, on the Discord. And if you have a Booze News theme, email it to the sloppyboyspodcast@gmail.com. And if you want to befriend Kyle, subscribe to our Patreon, join the Discord, and Kyle's going to be your buddy.
Do we want to befriend Kyle? What the fuck was that?
Well, I said King of Thrones.
I remember Mike saying King of Thrones.
Oh, right. King of Queens. You called Game of Thrones King of Thrones, and then we made fun of it, talking about like it's a King of Queens type show. Mm-hmm. And then he took the liberty of adding all the flatulence.
And then adds the farts, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because maybe Kevin
Which
James
is lowbrow, lowest common denominator like type shit.
I think that was Kevin James's character, one of his personality traits on that show. He farted all the time.
All right.
I watched Kevin James's new stand-up special on Netflix, and he's got a dyed beard. You know, much like Marshall Mathers, you know, when a guy has a jet black beard. And Kevin James has the has a bicked shaved head now and a big dark beard. And he kind of slimmed down. It's a whole new Kevin James.
Remember that meme?
That's a funny move. Oh, the meme is great where he just looks like a little shit.
Mm-hmm.
Another guy shaved his head and has the goatee. One of the 2.5 men.
You
know the guy? Yes.
He looks creepy. John Cryer.
Yes, Cryer, John Cryer not pulling off the look. Hopefully Kevin James is rocking it.
And he's got another, again, not pulling on. No, none of them are. And John Cryer has a new multi-game sitcom that's like, another go around the, here we go all over again.
Another go around the bend.
Another go around with with your stepkids this time.
I'm living in a situation that's a little different than usual, but also different than 2.5 men.
Oh, God. Yep. Yeah, John Cryer's got that look like, I know like Andrew Tate is a muscle man, I guess. Like he's got muscles. You know Andrew Tate.
I'm not sure who that is. Hold on.
He's like the, he's a toxic man.
Like you don't know who Andrew Tate is.
You know who Andrew Tate is?
But oh, yes,
like,
yes.
This he's guy. Got like a shaved head and a goatee and he just looks kind of like,
yeah,
kind of like a pushover. He looks kind of, I don't know.
A dingus.
It looks like a dingus. And he doesn't look like Charles Barkley or he doesn't look like, you know, definitely doesn't look like The Rock or Jason Statham.
Nah.
Damn.
No.
But I mean, I think that's just the playbook. Lots of guys, as soon as they're losing the hair, they just shave it. But I like a balding, like a you leave some fuzz back there, be a little shaggy back there. It's great. You look unique.
I think so. I think it's tough, though, if somebody's like a muscle man, that look is more of a 70s muscle man look.
What is?
The bald with the hair still, some fuzz in the
shit,
back.
Tell that to the Fast and the Furious crew. They all got that look.
I know, but that's... I would love to. I'd love to stop by set.
They should make a new Fast and Furious movie that's all... that they got flappy hair. You'd
fucking 13 celebrities? I'd love to have a day like that.
I'd love to have some of the biggest, both physically and box office celebrities in front of my face and me telling them that their hairstyle doesn't work.
It is funny, though, that like those movies, to me, literally would be better... if instead of just shiny cue balls and muscular, like if those guys had different flappy hair and different hairlines.
Funny wigs. Like, come on.
Well, it would just be like more to look at. You'd be like, well, that guy's got male pattern baldness. That guy's got a bald spot up top. This guy's got Ally Afridi hair.
More to look at. More to digest. More to digest, Tim. Some of these cars in this movie are going out to space.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you need more...
But Tim likes to tune into a human, you know? He doesn't love all that, like, flash and bang sort of stuff.
Nah. Yeah.
Also, on the bald head front, a whole cast bald head front, Breaking Bad. That was sort of like a thing they ultimately did. Like
Hank?
Hank.
Oh, yeah.
Jesse?
Walt eventually shaves his head. Jesse?
Walt?
Mm-hmm. And Mike Ehrmantraut.
Mike Ehrmantraut? Gus? Short hair is all around.
Jesus Christ.
And they say that short hair and like the receding hair is a trait of high testosterone. I think that's why all these things do it. Not us, low T.
That is funny. Three sloppy boys with three big pompadours. One sperm between us.
So wait, what's the actual booze news? We did the thing again where we
we're not supposed to talk.
Do we have any? No. I don't have any.
Okay. This was the type of thing that I like to ignore until it is sent to me by a disproportionate amount of slop heads, and I simply couldn't ignore it. And then I said, oh, I see why you're sending me this, because it might tick off a certain Mike Hanford. I'm linking you to it. But
tick off? That's not what I do this for.
A viral video on Instagram recently, drink called Shrek Piss.
Ah, yes.
It is a green, yellow Long Island iced tea type drink invented by the Instagram account Tipsy Goat Cocktails. Went viral. But Shrek piss comes right on the heels of Mike's Grimace piss.
It does. Suspiciously on the heels, yeah.
Suspiciously, yes, Jeff. I thank you for saying that. I couldn't finish that word. It's also coming. This might make a little sense time-wise. We came out with Grimace piss. They have more than enough time to get Shrek piss in the test kitchen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I don't like this.
They're hacks.
And like, is Shrek having a moment right now?
Oh, he's been having a moment since 2021. Yeah, but
Grimace was the star of the star of the month when you came out with
star of the month.
Grimace, you win star of the month.
I mean, McDonald's chose to make Grimace the star of that month. I think that Shrek is having like a resurgence in an ironic way. Like, did you see that there's like a Shrek rave, and there's all these ravers dressed like Shrek? It's like there's winky Shrek-y winkiness going around. I feel like that, you know, like remember a couple years ago, everyone was like referencing Frasier like it was the funniest reference. And then now Frasier is just back and you're like, well, reference it enough. And there you go.
Yeah.
Damn.
Wait, Shrek. I feel like Shrek's been sort of a funny, quote unquote, random punchline for like years.
Yeah. It's because like,
you know what I mean?
Like we were kind of too old for Shrek, really. Like people 5-10 years younger than us like grew up with Shrek, and that's like a funny reference. It's still good to them, you know. It's like Pokemon or Arthur or something.
Remember when Tim and Eric did a thing where they went to the Shrek movie
that was great. And
like green paint, they're like nobody was paying for it, and then
they just did ads,
just took it out on themselves to do a whole fleet of ads for what is it, Shrek 3.
They did a press junket and they were like, the weight is ogre.
The weight is ogre. Yeah.
Oh god. That's good.
Wait, but here, listen to the recipe here for Shrek piss. Is a whole you know, like it's in the genre of like an AMF or a Long Island. It's tequila, peach schnapps, gin, triple sec, sour apple pucker, watermelon pucker, Midori, sweet and sour mix, pineapple juice. So it's you know, like half ounce of a bunch of million different things.
Sure. And a bunch of those are bright green to start with, like Midori,
yeah.
Watermelon pucker, I assume.
You could probably lose a lot of these and still have the same effect, but they went. It doesn't seem like it's the type of drink that's made to be ingested, right? It feels like it's just an Instagram video.
Yeah, unlike the Grimace piss.
Right.
Grimace piss was meant to be brought onto a podcast and not really fully dialed in yet, and then have it taste really bad, and then have the creator act like it wasn't his fault.
Yeah, the three of us came up with that together. So the three of us made that and tested it.
The creator keeps saying that.
Yeah. The creator is very sticking to that point. He's sticking with that idea.
Yeah.
Very much.
You know, you don't see Steve Jobs out there saying like, actually, you know, we all did this.
No, because his products took off, some of them.
Yeah, but he's not out there trying to push the credit onto other people. He stands by his product.
Right, because he's got good quality products that everyone's buying. Okay. No one liked the Grimace piss, so now I need to bring others in.
Well, I like it over Shrek piss, Mike.
Thank you.
You will never catch me drinking Shrek piss.
Good.
Put some Boost Spits.
I'll never catch you drinking a Grimace piss again.
Maybe. You might.
Nice. Constantly.
Nice.
Is that it for Booze News?
Wrap it up. Excite bike.
That's wrapped.
That was great.
Does anyone know it?
Was it?
No. I'm gonna guess a Ninja Turtles.
No, close. So close. You couldn't be much closer, Mike.
Oh, Double Dragon.
Battletoads?
Yes, Battletoads.
Fuck. I never thought about that. Battletoads came after. Yeah. That's stupid.
But at least they didn't do like the, you know, they didn't try to do an analogy for every word in Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Right? Yeah. It wasn't like
Mighty Morphin Power Ranger.
Yeah. Adolescent freakazoid, middle-aged aardvarks or whatever.
That's not bad.
Okay, with booze news shrinking into the rear view once again, we turn our attention to the drink of the day. Bye. Who's got it?
I do. And we, you guys must recall a couple weeks ago that we did a drink called the Gin Fizz.
Oh, yeah. Still hung over from that one.
It was quite Tom Collins-y indeed, was it not?
Sure, but it did have that froth and it had that clonk, clonk, clonk ice.
Because due to the egg white, and we learned that a fizz is basically a sour with soda. And there were, in the late 1800s, early 1900s, there was a lot of fizzes. But today we're tackling the Big Mama, the one that made its way to the International Bartenders Association cocktail list.
Oof, and, which we are almost done.
The most popular.
Yeah, fine.
Yeah, we're in the home stretch on this one. But this here drink is called the Ramos Fizz. The Ramos. We got to say Ramos or Ramos. What were we going to say? Ramos I'm thinking Fizz.
Ramos. Ramos. You're thinking of Harold Ramis.
I've heard people say Ramos. I listened to some podcasts and watched some YouTube videos about this, but I'm going to say Ramos because I like it better. Ramos Fizz.
Me too.
You've had?
No.
I almost had, Tim, but you pulled it from our lips. We were going to do this one first, and you said, wait, we're doing Gin Fizz first so that we can build up to the big boy.
Ooh. I wanted to tiptoe in. Yes. Didn't
I? Yes.
I have had this one time at Musso and Frank. And it's a creamy drink, and it paired poorly with a steak. It was much like I liked the drink its own. I remember, but like remember when I had the lamb kidneys and a grasshopper?
Yeah. I was gonna say somebody had a grasshopper with a weird thing. It was you.
I'm too excited to try different cocktails there that I don't think about the pairing with my food, and then it's just fucking nasty.
Well, but they really like those creamy guys, huh? I bet you could get like a Brandy Alexander there and stuff.
You certainly can, Jefferson. But so the Ramos Fizz, this is a drink. Its big thing is that it's famous for how long you shake it. And there's lots of talk about the shake. How do you shake?
Now, is Ramos a famously shaky person?
That's what's
weird.
I'll shut up. He had such a steady hand.
So it was ironic. It was like calling a big guy tiny.
He was terrible at making these. No, this is one of the very rare cocktails that the IBA put the history on the website. They don't normally do that, but for this one,
it's good for podcasting, though. Can't, you know, don't look a gift horse in the mouth.
Yeah, here it is. It's brief. The drink was invented by Henry Ramos in 1888 at his bar Meyer's Table de Hotel International in New Orleans. The Ramos Fizz was originally shaken for 12 minutes by a crew of 30 bartenders who passed the shaker from one to another.
Yes.
Wow.
That's funny.
About that hotel, my other research shows that Henry Ramos actually, he invented it at that hotel, but then he opened his own bar called the Imperial Cabinet Saloon.
Oh, good for him.
That's where it got popular. And then the Fairmont Hotel bought the rights to the drink and popped it around to other cities. And that's what really made it spread coast to coast. But my understanding of this drink, I was kind of like, why, when? Like, I know you don't have it with a big steak, right, but it seems like it's a daytime drink. It's an afternoon, old-timey, post-lunch type of afternoon drink. When you're ready for something that's eggy and frothy, I guess.
It sounds like half your meal. Sounds like the back half of a meal.
It does feel like it would be like the original M-Drive meal replacement. Yeah, actually, right, no, M-Drive says you should eat a light breakfast with your M-Drive. Thank you very much.
Are you still on M-Drive?
Send me some more product. I finished my M-Drive, and I would love for them to send me more, but it's a hell of a powder, I'll tell you that.
Yeah. It looks good in the cup.
Oh, my God, please. Gorgeous. You know what? I don't have any of the normal protein left, but I do have M-Drive Brain and M-Drive Green.
You need those.
Ooh.
Okay, so folks, the thing with the drink is the shaking. No one's really doing the full 12 minute shake, but you know, Ramos had like shaker boys, like a line of boys, and then he'd pass it down and would shake. So these days at any classic cocktail bars that make it, there's strong opinions about how long you shake it for. And if you do the dry shake, do you not put the ice in? Do you put, when do you put the egg in? When do you put, do you add the soda when it's shaking, or what do you add the soda after? So, we're just going to stick to the IBA recipe here.
Good.
Which nice. Is 45 milliliters gin, 1.5 ounces, 15 milliliters fresh lemon juice, joie de limon, 1/2 ounce, 30 milliliters, 1 ounce sugar syrup. I'm guessing that's simple. 60 milliliters.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I have something to say about this. Go ahead.
Yeah. Why is there not uniformity? Why do they sometimes say
they do it with the soda water too? Because soda water is club soda, right?
Yes.
And they've said club soda in other menus, I believe. Yes, go ahead. It's just something that pisses me off.
60 milliliters, 2 ounces cream.
Cream.
I take that to be heavy whipping cream.
Okay, good.
Probably. So, yeah. 30 milliliters, 1 ounce egg white. Mm-hmm. Now we're getting fancy here, guys. 3 dashes orange flower water.
Yeah.
This was a tough one. Keep going.
I knew it.
You're almost done.
2 drops vanilla extract and soda water. Here's the method. Pour all ingredients except soda water into a cocktail shaker with ice. Shake for 2 minutes. Double strain in a glass. Pour the drink back in the shaker and hard shake without ice for 1 minute. Strain into a highball glass. Top up with soda.
Wow.
Okay. So wet shake before dry shake.
Yes. Yes.
I've never heard of such a thing. This is going
to
be.
What? I don't understand what the purpose would be to strain it, pour it back in, shake it. Because then you're just adding the topping up with the soda right at the end. I can't understand it.
I'm going to do it, but I don't understand what it's all about.
I mean, you know, it would be fun. This is usually we do this during the break, but it would be fun if we were doing 2 minutes of shaking on pod. That would be a funny thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it would be.
But we can't. We got to go in our kitchens and do it.
Yes. Yeah, it's also like we got to come up with a name or a distinction for drinks that are just like a pain in the ass to make.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, because there's so many drinks. I'm like, I don't know if I'd make it again. I'd order it again. But like
I call it the IBA 5.
It ruins my kitchen to make a drink like that.
Yeah. I mean, and this is like the foremost of those drinks. This drink is famous as an eye roll when you order it and a bartender goes, okay.
Okay, chat. You must have been listening to this lobby, boy.
Even on our pod, we avoided it for 3 years.
Yeah.
But not today, folks.
We're avoidant. Anxious avoidant.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Anxious avoidant.
That's our love language.
Right.
Attachment style.
Here's what I'll say. What are you guys doing for this orange water?
I'll tell you, Mike, I got the motherfucker.
Oh, what am I doing for the orange flower water? I got the shit. Yeah. What do you got?
Where'd you get it?
I was looking around. I was like, orange bitters. I bet you Hanford got orange bitters in replace of orange flower water.
Well, that doesn't seem fair to me. I looked it up and I saw that it was not orange bitters. So, but I looked up an alternative and I got an orange and it said just like do a bunch of expressing of the thing.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But what about the flower part? What about rose water? They got that there.
Oh, yeah. The thing didn't mention anything about that.
Okay. Interesting. Well, look, it's only 2 plops, you know?
Exactly.
Right. No, it's 3 dashes.
3 dashes.
I know. It's tough. It's going to have to be a lot of.
Well, 2 plops are actually 3 dashes.
Well, maybe I'll just put the whole peel in there and shake it with it. I called up the two liquor stores near me that have kind of extended. What am I trying to say? But more sophisticated product, and they didn't have this.
Damn. Okay.
Yeah, that's what I said. I said, "Damn." Okay, and I hung up.
Ding. All right, you want to get into it?
Yep.
Yeah.
All right, folks. We're staring this dragon right in the mouth. We're gonna do it today. We're gonna finally do it. So we're gonna go make these drinks while you listen to the ads, and we'll be right back. After this. back with the Ramos Fizz. Let's see him.
The fizz is the biz. I know, shaken, not stirred. Thank you.
It's hardest I ever
worked. Big frother. The 2 ounces of cream is a lot of cream, huh?
It is. I was looking at other recipes. Don't call for that much.
How big is your froth? Look how big that is. It's like 2 inches of froth.
I'm like all froth.
Yeah. It's getting hard, too. We should take our sips because I don't like this.
I know. And also to spend so much time like shaking with care and then to let it sit is sort of...
Yeah, I'm going
to
take my sip.
Okay, here we go. Sips.
Sips.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
I don't know.
I'm like fighting through a heavy meringue up top.
Yeah, the meringue is tough, but...
Yeah, mine it fully whipped into whipped cream, huh?
Fully whipped.
I know, I can't really get through, but the liquid beneath is good.
Mm. The liquid beneath.
What lies beneath, that's nice.
It could be an album title, The Liquid Beneath.
Mm.
I mean, this is unlike anything we have had on the podcast. It's whipped cream, thick Cool Whip on top. Yeah. That's why there's so much shaking. Jeff's got, suggestively creamy lips that he's licking off.
Oh, Jeff.
Come on. Not suggestively.
But it's just funny. Like, it's a thick, lathery meringue. And then the taste, you're getting like lemon, lime, and little seltzer bubbles in there. Mm-hmm. It certainly tastes like something from 1888.
Yes.
Yeah, that's true. Like when, as I was making it, I was thinking of, I never had these, but like an egg cream. Isn't that like a malt? Like an egg cream is like a malt, what is an egg cream?
I read that this was inspired by the egg cream because it's around that time.
Hmm. Okay. I like the taste of it.
Mm-hmm.
I really think that vanilla is pulling the champion's load on this one.
Pulling the champion's load?
I'm trying to get that going now.
Oh, yeah. That's what you want to get going of all the things?
Mm-hmm. That's the one.
I'm trying to make fetch happen.
No, don't make fetch happen. Did you see the new...
I want to. No, this year I finally want to.
How much do they talk about fetch in the new... the new high school... What's it called?
The new high school.
I was going to say High School Musical.
They touch on it in the new Fletch movie.
Stop trying to make fletch happen.
Yeah. The reason I said High School Musical is because it happens in high school and it's a musical.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Okay, you caught me.
Jeff, are you getting enough? Is your vanilla pulling the hero's load?
Yeah, it's pulling it.
I wish I was getting less citrus and more vanilla.
Me too.
This is putting me in the mood for a milkshake. Ooh, a shamrock shake with Jameson.
Ooh. Also, this is very close to my morir soñando.
Milk and OJ?
Yeah, it's like OJ milk, condensed milk, sugar, and vanilla extract.
It's got an Orange Julius thing going on.
I don't know. Okay, so now I am able to like drink through the foam, and that's nice.
It is funny to drink this foam, and it like you're like, oh, this is going to be a sweet treat, and it's just like doesn't have flavor.
Yeah,
it's got lemon.
Well, you're right, but it's not like a real pop of.
It tastes empty, cream. Right? There should be like a middle coming through
in the foam, or just the whole thing.
Just the whole thing, like, it's not a bad taste, but like, if you're going to have this much fat and this much calories, oh, wait a second.
It just feels.
Guys.
Weak. What?
I forgot. What? I forgot my simple syrup.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, you need it.
Drop a sugar cube in there.
Wait, how much do you put
now,
in?
Jeff, what were you going to say? I cut you off to make my
I was going to ask Tim if he'd rather shake this for 3 minutes or a can of Cardi B's whip shots.
Definitely this.
Really? Oh, you tried the whip shot. That's right.
I can't believe this shit. I'll be back.
All right. Gone.
Yeah, you got to.
Well, you know, it's a drink with so many unique ingredients. Of course you're going to forget something like simple syrup.
Got him.
I'm not out here to get anyone. I'm not here to put the big simple syrup on blast, but somebody's gonna.
I always have a shock of terror when I see that many ingredients because I know I got to cram them all into a little Photoshop tile for at the Sloppy Boys on Instagram.
You know, you might have to, and I hope you never have to do this, but you might have to go on a panel too.
Oh no! For the fucking ingredients,
we had to do that. Fuck. We had to do that for the fucking Tom and Jerry, which was similarly complicated. It was another one that had like egg and cream, and you got to shake it up. You got to get some stiff peaks.
I'll say, I think maybe the I don't know if we're here yet, Jeff. This is your show, but I would, one thing I would do without is maybe the club soda.
The club,
I feel
soda.
Like it adds no taste and is probably only diluting everything.
Yeah. I thought I didn't need it to get any foamier, and then I put in the club soda and it seemed to react and it like bubbled up.
Yeah, like, crazy. Look at this. I'm done, and I have this much foam left.
Yeah.
That's a lot of foam.
I'm drinking right through the foam and it's not budging. Like the foam just allows it by, and it's like a hockey puck in the middle of my glass.
Hey,
guys, I was a fool. Imagine this drink with no sweetness whatsoever. It was
that's
very empty and weird tasting. Then I added the simple, and now I understand why one would drink this. But I was also thinking, instead of sweetening it up with simple syrup, what if you had done like a Cointreau or you know, like
kick it up a little bit.
That takes care of your orange too.
Yeah, triple sec. Oh yeah, instead of simple, use triple sec is what I'm saying.
The orange spritzing I did, the expressing, I did like three or four peels, so I really got some. I am tasting the orange in here.
I tasted my orange.
Yeah, the orange flower water, I had to fight it to get it out of that glass.
Me too. Did you taste it straight? It tasted more like flower petals than orange.
Yeah.
It's just water that tasted like a flower, and it's not coming through in this drink at all.
It sucks.
I actually took a sip of mine before I added the club soda, and it was pretty good on its own.
Hmm. Yeah. I feel like you're losing a lot of drink too, just shaking and then discarding and then shaking again. I feel like you got like a whole quarter of the drink just coating the inside of that shaker. You're not getting it.
It's inefficient. It's a very inefficient drink.
Yeah, this is wild.
Did I tell you guys when I was grabbing ingredients today?
Grabbing the greed?
This was because this is one you do a shopping trip for. This isn't like, oh, I happen to have orange flower water. I happen to have heavy whipping cream.
Oh, yeah. This is I'm taking the afternoon off, boss.
Mm-hmm. I get into the Albertsons, you know, it's the one near Tim and me. And I hear there's this fighting going on in like one of the aisles. No, just like, not like that. Just like a couple arguing.
Fuck you, bastard. Oh, you bitch. Yeah, you bastard.
Mike, you're getting it. That's kind of how it was. And then I see this poor guy just taking all this heat. Oof. I was like, damn, it's too bad. Handsome fellow, though.
Okay.
Where you could tell...
hey, he's got something going on for him.
You could tell he was really handsome in like the 90s, 2000s. That's all. That's...
I know the look.
Yeah.
JTT haircut.
But you know me, I'm like, none of my business. I'm here for orange flower water.
Here for the beer.
Going on about my way. And then I'm looking through the orange flower waters and I hear, Dots, Dots. And he comes running up to me. He's like, I need your help, man. My girl's so mad at me.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, yeah. And I was like, you look so familiar to me. And he's like, yeah, I'm Enrique Iglesias.
Holy
you might recognize me.
Okay, he really cleared that up for you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Jeff. Okay, this is not the first time you've met a celebrity at the Albertsons. Go ahead.
No, I know. And like, I know.
It's Hollywood and I get it, but wow.
And he comes to me. He's like, does my girl's mad. What do I do? You know? And I was like, Enrique, I mean, I should be asking you this sort of stuff. And I'm like, I don't know, you know, you got to get back in her good graces. You know, I'm making this drink for the pod. And he saw the shopping list I had. And he said, can I borrow this for a minute? I was like, yeah, sure. If you think it'll help. And I saw him round the corner and he went to talk to his girl again. And I'm listening, right? I go, I want to hear, like, what's he up to? He's going to try and get back in his girlfriend's good graces with a bunch of ingredients on a list?
Yeah, what's he gonna hell? Do? That's not...
I don't understand how that's...
Look, I know we're into, you know, Cupid month, but I've never heard it done that way.
No. But so, you know what I did? I pulled out my phone and I pressed record on my voice memos. I want to hear this.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah, so this is what he said.
Oh my God, I can't believe he said this.
He said that?
Tonight we drink.
Take
a cocktail shaker in your hand. What lies in store?
Ooh, beautiful voice.
Lemon, lime, and simple me amor. Don't let the gin out your sight. Ooh, heavy cream, that's so nice. You mustn't forget the egg whites. Fizz Ramos. Combination buffalo, Fizz Ramos. Dash of orange, flour water, Fizz Ramos. Gonna shake it up forever, Fizz Ramos. And the color, mi amigo, it's yellow.
It's more white, really.
Well, in where he, how he makes them, they come out yellow. I don't
I
know.
See.
He's probably
putting the yolk in.
Yeah, he's probably puts the yolk
in. The end, hey, guys, in the end, they all come out yellow.
Huh? Yeah. And those two left happy as clams.
That's great.
Wow.
He sounded great. It almost sounded like he was double tracking on some of his conversation.
I think it was probably echoing off the Captain Crunch.
Boy, that's...
Yeah. Oh, that's what it was. You could hear it bouncing off the crunch.
That's amazing. That's great that you got him.
Happy to help. If you see me at the Albertsons, I'll do what I can to help you out of a jam.
So wait, what was the argument about? Just the ingredients?
Lover's quarrel, Mike. That's that is. So
gotcha. It's just the way it is sometimes with lovers.
Yeah.
That's great. I like that he said instead of Ramos Fizz, he said Fizz Ramos.
Yeah.
Because there as
Fizz,
I am
comma Ramos.
Right. I'm doing Duolingo Spanish, as some of you know. I'm about 427 days in. So yeah. Over a year.
Do they flip that stuff?
Wait, 427 days is over a year?
It's over a year. Yeah. If you're saying like a tomato salad, you say ensalada de tomato.
That's probably what it is.
He's right. Just kind of flipping it, you know, because he's a Spanish native, Spanish speaking guy.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it is.
That's what it is. That's what happened.
All right. What would you do to change up the drink and make it more to your liking?
More vanilla, less soda.
Yeah. Is this a strong drink?
I mean,
2 ounces gin.
It's normal. Most cocktails start with 2 ounces, and then there's no other alcohol in there. So,
I don't know. I feel like with this drink, I don't know what to change because there's so much stuff in it.
Yeah.
I would add vanilla because I like that. And would you say, Tim, less soda? That would probably be the way to go too. I would maybe do less lemon too.
Oh.
I would do less lemon if I could do less lemon lime, more. OJ, I think this would be
what? Yeah, why is it lemon and lime? Is it fucking Sprite?
Yeah,
hey. yeah.
Is it fucking Sierra? Fuck motherfucking Mist.
Hey, it's Sprite. Sorry, not Starry.
Yeah, what is this fucking half of a Five Alive? Basically,
is this the Uncola 7-Up?
Yeah. All right. Too many ingredients. Damn. It needs tweaks.
This drink makes me act weird. It's the drink.
It's the drink, you see.
Yeah. Well, are we making another one? It is a pain in the ass, but like, here we are. We got the stuff.
I'm going to do such a tweak on this, you won't even know it hit you.
Oh, wow. Okay. Coming up.
I'll be honest. I don't really want a second one, but I have all this bullshit. And if I know, don't I'm have gonna... it now, I'm never going to have another one. I don't know how I would get through this bottle of cream that I bought. So, yes, I'm going to make a second one.
Hey, 'tis the season.
There you go.
Hey, now, you know what I'm going to do with this cream? Because I bought eggs, too.
What?
Tomorrow, when I make some scrambled eggs,
yeah,
I'll put a little cream in that. Fluff them right up.
Oh, Michael.
Fluff that shit right up.
Let's address this, because I make scrambled eggs on the regular.
Scrambled.
And I used to do...
No, Mike, it's scrambled.
Milk. Like a little dollop. And then...
Hold on, Jeff.
No, hold on.
You said
I just want to say something.
Crystal clear. You said the word you meant to say, and it was correct. And then Mike chimes in with scrambled. Scrambled.
Here's what happens. And we're using some brand new digital video system where we can see each other. I think that this new system, what's it called? Restream studio.io. What's I.io?
Don't plug them.
Anyway, yeah, don't plug Restream. But here's what I want to say. It's one of these systems, I've read about this before in popular mechanics, tech magazines, that there are platforms like this that do turn bees upside down.
Oh.
Yes. Oh. So that's where that was.
Okay.
Mike, I owe you an apology.
You're probably hearing it now. When I'm saying scrambled, you're hearing scrambled, yeah. Right?
Yeah. That's probably, it's probably compression. Oh,
totally. It sounds like scrambled, but you're saying scrambled.
Right. But it's coming out. I'm going to do it again. Scrambled. Yeah. So that sucks. So that's maybe going to be the last time we use this.
Okay. Well, I apologize. And yeah, this whole thing was a big misunderstanding.
This whole thing is fucked. I just want to say you're supposed to use water in scrambled eggs, not milk. Is that true?
No.
Water?
Yep.
No, water. I think that's wrong.
Water.
That'd be wrong to do.
No, I'm saying a little sprinkle of water instead of, and you're going to go to cream? That sounds extra wrong to me.
I do just egg. Egg, salt, pepper, a lot of butter in the pan. But you got to do a real soft scramble. Real soft.
That soft scrambles, that's a fun one. If you can get it
just right. When I'm in a diner, right, I order soft scrambled. Oh, that's Timmy. Good.
That's good for you, Tim. I'm going to put some cheese in this.
That's good for me.
I'm putting cheese in these eggs. Ooh, and I heard what you said about the pepper and salt, but I'm going to put in a dash. And I mean just a half dash of garlic salt.
Okay. Oh, Michael.
Mike knows what he likes. All right, folks. We're going to go make these drinks round two. And we'll be right back here after this.
Fizz Ramos!
And we're back with round two of the Ramos Fizz. I did the same thing, more vanilla extract and a full shot of Cointreau.
Okay.
Wow, Jeff.
Ooh, Cointreau, nice.
I cranked up the vanilla, cranked down the soda.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. Better, better, better.
Yeah, it's better for me too. It's more orange Julius.
Yeah, that's what I was going for. I'm not achieving it. I got I squeezed a half an orange and then added a lot more vanilla, cream, and gin. That's all I did. And sugar.
Damn.
Simple sugar or simple syrup.
Gin is in.
And it's not very good. Something's wrong here. I wanted an orange Julius with just a hint of alcohol in it. Yeah. One has no foam though.
I'm jealous of Jeff. I wish I had the orange Julius thing. Does this I don't know, a lemon lime milkshake? It's weird. Orange milkshake is good.
Yeah. I even think adding another 30 mil of liquid kind of changed up the chemistry. I don't have that thick brick of foam up top. It's a little bit more like worked in.
Oh, interesting. Oh,
yeah, you know?
And you said you did put the club soda in it?
I did it. I did it to specs, but with just more vanilla and a shot of Cointreau.
Okay.
Huh.
Oh, yeah. Maybe that Cointreau is eating it away. It's acidic.
Mmm. Ooh, that French Cointreau is getting into that Spanish fizz. Ching, oh. Ching, ching. En garde.
Oh, I wish I knew a war where they were fighting in. War of the Roses? No, that's got to be England, I would assume. In the old days.
Well, we come to the time for final thoughts. Mike and Timothy, submit your feelings to the triumvirate.
I say I'm going to order it again. I don't feel like I had a good one of these. I need to order again just to get the... This is a real, I need a professional to make this one for me.
Yeah. I'm with you.
This might be a first. Mike said order again. Tim says not gonna order again. I'm intrigued by the froth, but lemon and lime in a creamy drink are simply not doing it for the tea, man. And even with the sugar in there, I still think it's lacking a middle. And I don't know what that is. Something's got to punch right through the middle. Maybe the triple sec did it.
So we got the bass, boom, 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 and we got the treble.
Yeah, where are those nice rich mids?
Yeah. Where is somebody like me gonna fit into the string?
Can I tell you something?
Instead of my plays,
instead of gin, dark rum.
Ooh, that would stank it up.
That's good, Tim. That's that would give us that it. Flavor.
Timmy, you've done it, Timmy. You've done it again.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, as I expected, this is for me not an order again so much as a... No. I'm sorry. It is an order again, but it is not a make again.
Yeah, right.
Definitely yes, not. I'm with you. Ooh, my kitchen is trashed, man. It's so gross.
Yeah, it sucks. Me too. Egg, cream... And like actual ingredients like vanilla extract? Come on.
Damn, Jeff, aside from the vanilla extract, you sound like the scrambled eggs I'm going to make tomorrow.
Oh, God.
Oh, it turned your bee upside down again.
It did again? Fuck. I thought there was a setting. I was fucking with some settings.
Damn.
A setting. There's a setting that says bees right side up.
Yeah. I want those up.
But you got to untick that box.
I know I did, but I think I need to restart the whole thing.
Damn. That's our show. Follow us on social media at The Sloppy Boys, where we release these recipes ahead of time. And if you can't get enough boys, go to patreon.com/The Sloppy Boys and double your pleasure every week with The Sloppy Boys Blowout, our weekly bonus episode that's not about cocktails. It's about any other thing. For example, this week we're talking 8 Mile starring Marshall Mathers. That's right.
Oh, I thought you had more to say.
Well, I was enjoying. I was kicking back. I was sort of nodding my head like, this guy's fucking, this fucking knocks, dude. Brittany Murphy, Kim Basinger, and who would have thought? Michael Shannon. All right, folks.
I know.
We talked about that on the pod. We talked about
it. We'll save it for the... Okay, all right. Good episode, dudes. And good episode, those of you listening at home, you're part of this, too.
Yes.
Yeah, great work.
And if you're seeing us, we've got the video to work.
Congrats,
guys. We like that.
Wow. Sorry about the bees being upside down. Otherwise, this was great.
Yeah, fuck that.
We'll iron that out for next week, I hope.
I'd have to go back and listen, but maybe that was the only word with a B I said in it. In the whole episode, I mean. Okay, well, I'll listen back.
Oh, anyway. Give it a sample.
Bye, folks.
Bye, folks.
Love you. Bye.